Hello everybody, welcome to another interesting and important video with situational interview questions for aspiring data analysts. With such questions, the interviewers don't try to check your knowledge. What they're actually interested in is your problem solving ability and overall approach. The way you tackle these problems showcases your analytical thinking ability, which is very, very important for this role. These are some of the most important type of questions, and neglecting to prepare for them means that you are setting yourself up for unexpected surprises at the interview, which I'm sure none of us likes. So let's see some important questions based on the real world scenario. And today, rather than giving you the sample answers, I'll guide you through the process of digging deeper into these problems and developing thoughtful solutions. Every single part of this video is very, very important. Make sure that you do not skip any of these parts. Ready? Fantastic. Let's dive in. Question number one, you are required to analyze the customer behavior on an e-commerce platform and you notice a sudden abandonment of cart. How would you investigate and explain this? Okay, so first of all, let us understand what is cart abandonment. Cart abandonment means a customer added the product to their cart, but they left midway without actually buying it. Now, you can understand that this is a very big concern for any e-commerce company, as it directly impacts their sales and revenue. Now, to answer this question, what's important is the type of things you think about or the questions you ask to understand the problem better. The best way to answer such questions is think aloud in a little structured way. And for this, the first thing that you have to do is dig deeper. Try to find answers to questions like, is there any particular product which is facing this problem? Is there any particular time of the day, geographical area which observes more of this? Has there been any technical change made to the platform recently after which this has started happening? Is there anything common between the customers who abandon their carts, age, geography, items they buy, anything? Check the checkout process yourself to find the potential issues. Now, based on the pattern that you have identified, form a hypothesis for this cart abandonment, which could be the customers abandon their carts because of trust issues or technical problems or confusing or difficult checkout process or high shipping cost or price higher than the last time, etc. To test these hypotheses, you can perform A/B testing, analyze user experiences and carry out user surveys as required. Finally, based on your findings, you can develop a report with your recommendations. So you see, what's important is the follow-up questions you ask. You may want to ask them to the stakeholders to understand their experience or carry out your own investigation in that direction. But ultimately, what's important is this thought process. Okay, let's see the second question. Question number two. A company wants to install a cold beverages vending machine in a new mall. It needs to calculate the quantity of beverages to be filled in the machine and the refilling frequency. How would you go about solving this puzzle and give the output data to your client? Another interesting problem. Let's break it down so that we can solve it. And for that, your step number one is understand the problem clearly. Here, we have to find out the quantity of beverages to be filled in the vending machine initially and how often should it be refilled. Your step number two is digging deeper, that is asking relevant questions. So here you can ask questions like, what type of beverages would the machine offer? What is their nature, variety, etc.? What is the capacity of the vending machine? What is the expected footfall in the mall during the weekdays, weekends, and peak hours? What is the popularity of each beverage based on any past data that you might have? And then what is the effect of seasonality on the demand for this particular beverage? That is, what is the effect of the weather, any special event that they might have, etc. Then what is the shelf life of each of these beverages? Now, based on all the information that you have collected, based on all the data that you have collected, in step number two, carry out your statistical calculations. And then prepare your report for the client. Here, you'll have to explain the rationale behind these calculations, any assumptions that you might have made, any past experiences that you have considered, cost considerations, etc. What's important here is to keep monitoring the performance of the machines and make any adjustments as required. So you see how important it is to take a step back and think for a few seconds before you answer this type of questions. For these type of questions, the time that you take to structure your thoughts and present a logical answer always works in your favor. Don't jump at solving the questions. Rather, focus on asking the counter questions. That is going to help you. Okay, let's move on to question number three now. Question number three. A cloud kitchen wants to expand its business by increasing its delivery service to new areas. It wants to know which location would be most profitable. How would you solve this puzzle and recommend the best areas for expansion? Fantastic. Another interesting question. Let's see how to probe it. The goal here is to identify the most profitable areas for this cloud kitchen to expand its delivery services. To do this, the type of questions that a data analyst needs to ask are, number one, do we have the sales data, order history, and customer demographics for the existing delivery areas? This data can provide us a foundation to begin with. Number two, what is the average order value, order frequency, customer retention, and delivery cost in existing areas? Number three, what are the new proposed areas? Number four, what is the population density, income levels, preferred cuisine type in the new area? Is there any existing competition already there in those areas? What average order value, order frequency, customer retention, and delivery cost do we expect in the new area? How much would be the cost of opening a new outlet in those areas? Do we plan to do any marketing and promotion activities? Now, when you carry out your analysis, taking the answers to these questions into consideration, you will be in a position to offer an informed suggestion to your client. See, with these questions, I'm trying to give you an idea about how to train your mind to think, the type of follow-up questions you should think about and ask. Not necessarily these questions will be asked as it is in your interview, but being aware of them gives your mind a direction to think in. So here are two more questions which you can use for practice purpose. I encourage all of you to share your thinking pattern and the follow-up questions in the comments box below. The first practice question here is, suppose you are working on a project for a travel agency client. They are worried about the sudden rise in cancellations for a popular vacation package. As a data analyst, you are required to identify the underlying causes for this and provide recommendations to reduce these cancellations. What would be your approach? Okay, and the second practice question here is, the planning in charge for a metro project in the city has hired you to help him decide the number of stations and their location. As a data analyst, how would you go about doing this project? So do share your approach to deal with these projects in the comment section below. If you recently faced an interview, do let us know what situational questions were asked to you. It will be helpful to all of us. And I sincerely hope that whatever we have learned in today's video will help you in cracking your next interview. If you have found today's video useful, do give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends too. To stay updated with more such enriching videos, subscribe the channel. I'll see you very soon with a new video. Till then, bye-bye and take care.